Are you guys ready for your next comedian?
This place is like kind of our whole lives. Yeah. It's kind of where our lives started, really.
It's the cradle, it's the womb for me, it's everything. And I met her.
Yeah.
We met here.
Hi, San Francisco, how are you? Good, it's good to be back.
I've seen Dave Chappelle do 5-hour shows. I've seen Robin Williams do a surprise set in there. If there was no Punchline Comedy Club, we wouldn't be talking right now.
The Punchline is threatened with closure.
I just found out, it's really heartbreaking.
If you let an institution like that go, you're really gonna kill part of the city's heart, at least for me. This is about how San Francisco defines itself and what San Francisco wants to be defined as.
We just have to save this place.
It's been here for 40 years while the whole rest of the city's grown up around it. You can't even see it from the street. All the way up this dark staircase, across a courtyard, and around the corner sits the little spot so many famous comedians call home.
Back when I left San Francisco, there weren't as many billionaires.
There's no escaping it. Outside these four walls, San Francisco is changing.
When I see a rat in my building, I'm like, good, thank you. You're my rent control, Mr. Squeaks. Good job.
If you ask Will and Debbie Durst, change is just part of city living.
It's always changing.
Yeah, my parents complained about the Transamerica building. Oh, how can they put that up? That's so crazy.
But since the night they met in this very room, one thing hasn't changed.
When you finally made it to that stage.
I meant you were a real working comedian.
When I was just starting stand-up, this was the center of my whole life. Like, getting on stage here was the goal.
For two generations of comics, the Punchline's Sunday showcase was a rite of passage.
This is the bar area where we all waited. This is where we spent our 10 months or a year waiting to go up on a Sunday, and we'd
This is like the bench.
This is the bench. Yeah, we're all sitting on the bench. Just, put me in, coach. Today's going to be the day and all this stuff.
Lined up along the bar, they'd wait week after week for the manager to call them up.
She kind of walked back and forth like Darth Vader, and you didn't know whether you were going to get picked or not.
I can remember going there, 27 years ago now? And desperate to get on that stage.
Greg Proops went on to fill bigger clubs and huge theaters, but the Punchline is still his favorite.
He can do close-up comedy, and by that I mean I can raise an eyebrow, I can cast a glance, I can do something very subtle and small, and it'll play to every seat in the room.
The club is dark and cramped, and that's exactly how comics like it.
The laughs of the audience would bounce off that brick and
ricochet through the room.
So the audience thought they were having a much better time than they actually were.
Dude, you want a little squinch of the snarf right now?
It's a room where comics of a new generation get to meet their heroes.
It's basically Chappelle's favorite club.
Yeah.
Chappelle comes here all the time.
And those heroes get to meet superheroes.
That was the last place I saw Robin Williams alive.
Dave Chappelle is here on business.
Displacement is actually not a laughing matter.
Local leaders and comedy greats were surprised to learn the Punchline was told it's losing its lease.
San Francisco is shutting down all kinds of things and pushing all kinds of people out.
The club's owned by Live Nation, a big company with no problem paying the rent. Its landlord is One Maritime Plaza, an office building owned by Morgan Stanley, which declined our request for comment.
The folks behind me figured out that the likely lessee is Google.
Google confirmed it is leasing the space next door, but said it was looking forward to being the Punchline's neighbor.
It's not like I hear they're turning it into a better comedy club or a new comedy club. It sounds like it's probably going to be a closet for some tech company's bicycles.
When comedians hold a press conference, things are bound to get interesting.
Trying to save a club that's owned by a big corporation from displacement by an even bigger corporation.
Most of it wasn't the stuff you can put on TV.
Just this morning, I saw a millionaire on the sidewalk.
He said, well, what kind of are you?
W. Kamau Bell offered the club a new home.
Punchline, we will take you in Oakland. I live over there now. Oh, that's too much. NATO said Tom Amiano dropped the gay F-bomb, but I said too much by saying Oakland. Got it. All right.
But Supervisor Aaron Peskin proposed legislation.
An interim zoning moratorium which will prevent the conversion from an entertainment use to any other use as a matter of law.
After the press conference, Google responded it wants to keep the club open and is willing to talk to city officials about preserving what Chappelle calls a piece of history.
The Punchline is, it's not just a San Francisco phenomenon, it's one of the premier comedy clubs in all the country. It'd be like burning down the Louvre.
And if he seems at home up here.
Will you run for office?
That's a terrible question.
For Chappelle, like so many others, the Punchline is filled with memories.
Back at the home club. This is very nostalgic for me.
Including the kind of memories some would rather forget.
I ended up crying on stage in a funny way. I was like crying, laughing through the tears. My therapist gave me a standing ovation. And everyone else was sitting down.
That means you won therapy.
That means I won therapy.